16 finals that they played in this year. You take a look at the rules. It's best 2 out of 3 games. First 2 games played to 21 points. If we go to a third, it's played to 15. It's rally scoring, which means a point every single play, and you must win each game by 2 points.
Misty May is toeing the line. She will put up the rock first and be the first to serve. This crowd on hand, getting treated to the best of the beach competition. And we'll see a bit later on, Sean Scott, the men's competition defending winner of the best of beach last year. He gets a chance to move on as well to the semis. 28 years of age, Misty Wayne putting it in play.
And line up.
Yeah. Well, they draw first blood right there. Kerri shooting so well. Block at the net.
Kerri did a great job of staying home, staying in front of Rachel Wacholder. They try to move her into the middle of the court. Nice job pressing the hands over the net. That's exactly how she wants to start off.
Rachel finding that open court. Well, these teams are no stranger to each other, are they?
No, they've played each other 17 times this year.
Rachel Wacholder making her home in Manhattan Beach. Just long. Early 2-1 advantage. Kerri Walsh, of course, the fantastic career at Stanford, now living in Redondo Beach, about to get married to Casey Jennings in a couple months.
December 4th.
You'll be there.
I will, with bells on.
Rachel, early on, finding those open spots. Kerri just unable to get there.
You know, Mary talked about her ab feeling much better. You can tell right there, Kerri went for that ball and laid out. She wasn't worried about anything.
EY, 35 years of age, making her home now in Durango, Colorado. EY unable to convert on that serve, but she does lead the tour in aces, so we'll expect to see some bombs coming from her today. Back to Misty. We've gone through the rotation one time. They lead 3-2.
Okay. My line, better. Good, good.
It's a great set by EY, and this year she has become one of the best setters on tour. She does a great job with her hands, nice and quick, and right there with her platform out, she bump sets that ball fast. That's tough to do.
Yeah. We're tied at threes. And it is just wide. You hear EY calling. That's a great eye at the turn. They now have the lead. It's Elaine Youngs and Rachel Wacholder with the be considered the best of the beach. They've got to get through this semi, and then, of course, there's another team waiting. We'll get to that semifinal, of course, in a little bit, let you know who's playing there. But as we speak, right now, it is EY and Rachel in front by one. And Peter, we've talked about, of course, most improved. Well, let's talk about the MVP candidates. There are three of them as you see it.
Well, Misty May Trainer, I think, is the front runner, especially after the individual tournament in Las Vegas. She really showed that she's having a phenomenal year with Kerri Hurt in Chicago, as well as Kerri played. Misty really stepped it up, and I think it might be her year. But you can't count out Kerri because she's the 2-time reigning MVP, and EY's had the best season she's had in years.
And as you say that, Kerri Walsh puts it down, finds the open corner, and she's got EY and Rachel talking on court. She's got them questioning their strategy.
Now, EY and Rachel have had a lot of discussions, and they've been intense ones. Yesterday, they lost in the early rounds to Diane Denekashe and Tammy Leibel, and EY was not happy. So they came out this morning. They did win this morning against the Brazilians, but you can tell it was an intense environment.
Kerri puts it up. Let's talk about that tension a little bit, or more important, the intensity. I mean, we're going to talk with the men, a lot of guys from Punahou High School down here maybe coming with the pressure to do well. But I think, honestly, the pressure really is on EY and Rachel to come down here and play the better game.
Oh, yeah, and EY and Rachel, now that they've beaten Misty and Kerri 4 times this year, and every time they play it seems close, they expect to win now every single time. They think they're the number one team.
As you have to if you're going up against the Olympic champions. And right there, Rachel Wacholder.
A lot of it's confidence, and they finally got that confidence when they defeated them in Cincinnati. And since then, it's been pretty even when they play. You take a look at Rachel going to the left side. See how she faces the blocker, and then she goes wrist away? That's a very tough shot to stop.
Makes it look easy, and there you see the stat. 3 wins this season, Cincinnati, Huntington, and of course, that dramatic win in Boulder. EY hands up, and it falls on the other side of the net. Good for a 3-point lead.
Right here, you're going to watch EY do a great job. What a tough shot to stop, but she dives into the angle, takes away that cut shot with her right hand, and there's the reaction.
That intensity that we talk about, you don't think she wants that?
Yes, good.
Almost another one.
You know, you talk about the intensity. Rachel can handle it. That's what's great about Rachel Wacholder. EY is going to be the emotional leader, and if she gets mad sometimes or upset, she lets everyone know. Rachel handles it very well. And that Liz Massakine also does a great job, who's their coach.
And most teams need that, don't they? You need the fiery person.
Absolutely.
And you need the cool, calm breeze. EY with a great shot down the line, keeping that 3-point cushion. Rachel with the serve. Kerri Walsh gets to show off a little bit there.
Yeah, Kerri Walsh after a little hammer down the line.
With the score, 8-6 advantage, EY and Rachel. We will take our first break. It's the Paul Mitchell Best of the Beach. Stay with us.
We believe in the great one and the next one. Monday, top draft pick Sidney Crosby makes his national debut. We believe this Penguin will fly.
Crosby turns on the jet.
And on Tuesday, the great one sets up in his new office. But it's Mike Madonna and the Dallas Stars who look to take care of business. We believe in shooting stars.
He scored!
The NHL on OLN. Penguin Sabres, Coyote Stars. Monday and Tuesday, live.
Let's go, you know the routine. Turn to your left.
Let's go, to your left. Turn to your right. Today, huh? Today.
Take your time now.
Okay, face forward.
Okay. Who did it?
Bud Light, proud sponsor of the AVP.
Dane set me up. He set me up.
Auto Zones, get in the zone quiz. Is this A, a garden tool, B, modern art, or C, a crankshaft for a 93 F-150? If you said C, congratulations, you're already in the zone. Auto Zone, with over 750,000 parts to get the job done right. Get in the zone, Auto Zone.
31 points of view you've never heard. 31 borders you've never crossed. 31 histories you've never seen before. Globalize yourself. All this month, only on History International. Call your cable or satellite provider.
Hope is more powerful than a hurricane. Help victims of Hurricane Katrina and thousands of other disasters across the country each year. Call or visit redcross.org.
The AVP Nissan Series on OLN is brought to you by Nissan, who reminds you to shift the way you move through the world.
We welcome you back to the island of Oahu, the season-ending tournament here in the AVP. EY and Rachel lead 8-6 early in game number one.
Dig, open hand, right to the target. Walsh makes the perfect transition set, which he usually does, and May, doing it like nobody else, just bombing from the right side.
She's done it for so long, it's just we expect it of her, don't we? They've closed within one.
Good, good. Right here, right here.
Miss hit right there. It goes just wide, and we are tied, Gator.
10-3 versus Wacholder and Youngs this season. 4-0 in the semifinals. 5-3 in the finals. That's on the AVP tour.
That's right. There was another win in the semis to make it 5-0, the FIVB tour, the international tour. So it would be safe to say that Misty May and Kerri Walsh have owned EY and Rachel in the semis.
In the semifinals, yes. But when a team beats the number one team four times, you have to take notice.
You do.
And this team hasn't lost four times in 2 years.
Well, EY and Rachel just scored to end a 3-0 run for Misty and Kerri. But again, that cross court.
You know, talking to Kerri yesterday, I said, how difficult was it to not practice this year very much? Because everyone is well documented that they were just traveling so much and they never practiced. She said it really affected them in tight situations at the end of the game. They were used to training 4 to 5 days a week.
Right.
And then they just go and just play tournaments. So you get to the end of the game. They did have some rare mistakes hitting balls out of the game, which no one ever saw them do before.
Well, yeah. And we know Kerri and Misty are more than willing to admit. There we go. It goes down. But more than willing to admit when they need the work. Dane Selzig, their coach, tells us the same thing. He couldn't believe how well they kept it together not practicing.
Take a look at Misty puts up that ball perfect. And Kerri Walsh, but that's a great time for her to hit on to. She puts the ball up nice and easy where she has the opportunity to either set it or attack it. Walsh goes up and just taps the right block. She knows Rachel's not there.
Here we go, Rachel. Kessier up. Game number one.
Take a look at Rachel Wacholder's ankle, of course. Not necessarily hampered, but that's been an issue the latter part of the season. EY goes over on two this time, so turnabout is fair play. We're tied at 10.
You know, I asked Dane before the game, the coach of Misty May and Kerri Walsh, are you going to serve Rachel deep? He's all, I don't really like to serve her deep because everyone wants to serve her deep. They think they get EY out of the play. But Rachel's so good at passing that ball nice and high, EY has a chance to feast on it.
EY gets a second chance, and she makes good at the turn. 11-10, EY and Rachel up early, and they have kept their lead as we take a break at 21. Let's take a look at some of the other teams that took part in the Best of the Beach down here in Honolulu, Hawaii. And here you see Bush and McSorley. Good chance for them to come down here, Gator.
Yeah, and you know what? It's nice that they made this event. You know, Leanne didn't start playing until midway through the year. So they made a nice little run at the end of the season.
Turner and Makari Wilson.
They're a great physical ball club. They finally cracked the Final Four twice this year. They just need to get a little bit better handling the ball. They could maybe make the final.
Brooke Niles and Sarah Stratt,
the 8-seeded team. They came together in Cincinnati and have just had a phenomenal year. They're one of those teams, too, that next year you can look for them to crack the Final Four.
And speaking of next year, I think the Brazilians will be back, won't they?
They're good. You got there, if you take a look, that's Tachi, the veteran. Great server. She played unbelievable in Vegas.
There you see those final standings, ties for fifth, ties for seventh. Of course, only the top eight teams came down here. So somewhat of a short weekend for these teams, but that doesn't mean the pressure's still not on.
Especially when there's a lot of money on the line.
The Paul Mitchell Best of the Beach. We've still got a few places to go. Fifth and seventh have been decided, but this semifinal will determine, as will the other semifinal on the outer court, who will get third or fourth, and then we'll get to our final.
You know, it is a relaxed atmosphere when you're at the end of the year. The last event in Hawaii is only 18. A lot of players are on the stage. Everyone's kind of hanging out, but it's also a tough time because you've gone through a long process of playing with each other. Some people are frustrated. You're trying to rejuvenate a little bit, maybe end on a good note. People are kind of looking around going, huh, maybe I should play with someone else next year.
I was just going to say, as we get through this telecast, we're going to have to do a little prognosticating, partner. I'm going to put you on the spot, see if there is going to be perhaps a shuffle or a shakeup in the teams.
Well, I can guarantee you that these two teams will be staying together.
I think that's a safe bet. Just wide. Miss hit.
See the reaction of Elaine Young. She's very disappointed. She wanted to put that set a little closer to the net. Rachel was pretty far off there attacking after a nice dig.
Third miscue for Rachel so far this game. We're knotted at 11s. A little bit of heat there.
You know, we saw the Chinese team that came in early in the year with that quick set, and then Brazil did it as well. Well, EY and Rachel have adopted it, and they do it better than anyone on the tour. EY with that great quick handset. Rachel comes in firing. A lot of opportunities to hit hard or shoot around the block. Very difficult to stop.
EY sends it just long. We are even yet again. EY in her 99th Final Four. It's a pretty impressive stat. Finds the corner.
You know, Jane Selznick told me that in Manhattan Beach, their strategy was to pin Rachel to the line. And they could stop. They could be more effective against her blocking and defense. Well, since that time, they heard that when they were watching the tape on TV. They've worked on bringing Rachel in the middle. And if you watch, they'll bring Rachel in the middle a lot. Every opportunity they get.
Off the block. It goes out. Good for a point. And good for another tie.
13's on the board.
Jen Kessie and Holly McPeak playing outside against Tammy Leibel and Diane Hecksey. And they are up. One game, we're told.
Kerri Walsh just extended that long right arm. Got herself a block.
Second game getting underway on the outer court. And of course, get into the final. Goes down, and we've got a two-point cushion. That's been rare in this game, Geeter.
15-13, Main Walsh on a little run.
15-13, a little timeout.
Let's send it out to court number one, just outside stadium court, about to begin game number two, Geeter, and as we said, there is that score.
And this is a rematch of yesterday's game. That was the first match played. Diane and Tammy defeated Jen Kessie and Holly McPeak, and now they're having a little rematch. And Kessie and McPeak need to get to a final. They are dying to get to a final. Tammy Leibel does a little jump float serve. Holly McPeak passes it. She's attacking.
Well, all these teams do a great job of handling the pressure, but I think some of the most pressure this year has been on Holly McPeak and Jen Kessie.
Absolutely. Just saw Jen Kessie roofing Diane Dinegashe. There's not a question about it. Jen Kessie gets a chance to play with the winningest player of all time. They've only been to one final. They've come up short quite often. In Chicago, they had a golden opportunity. They beat EY and Rachel, put themselves in the semifinal opposite side of Kerri Walsh and Misty May, and they lost.
And most people who follow volleyball know, but if you're new to the game, the soap opera continues because, of course, Holly McPeak and Elaine Youngs were partners last year. Holly McPeak choosing to move on, picks up Jen Kessie, and that, I think, has added to the drama this summer whenever those two teams meet.
Yeah, there's no question. Their relationship is still strong. They still remain friends, but you know, I know it's tough for Holly because she wants to be the ones to beat Misty and Kerri, and she looks, and you know, Rachel and Elaine have done it four times.
Well, yeah, you said earlier, I mean, Elaine Young expects to beat these guys and thinks of herself as the number one team on tour, and Holly McPeak, no different. Well, they're having a great run out there on the outer court. We'll bring it back inside stadium court as we leave Kessie McPeak leading 1-0 and 2-1 in the second game. Well, May and Walsh trailed 8-5, but since then have been on a 10-5 run. Yet another miss hit, 11-5 run now. Let's throw it down to Mary Strong for a bit more on an injury update. Mary.
That's right. You might notice Rachel has her left ankle taped. She usually just has her foot taped. Apparently, the pain in her foot has been moving up her ankle, and it feels very weak. So she decided to tape it yesterday and today to prevent any further injury or a possible sprain.
Thanks, Mary. We'll get her again to touch on. To touch on that injury, we'll do that in a second as we go to break. We're coming to the close of game number one, but there's still a lot more action. Stay with us.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm waiting.
Come on, let's go.
Where?
Over there.
What's your name?
Jerry.
Jerry.
Makes the point totals, Geeter, in order to... to get here and actually play in Hawaii, and that is a who's who of women's volleyball.
It is, and Misty Bay and Kerri Walsh ended the season number one, so they got the brand new cars.
Mm-hmm.
Did that in Chicago.
Compliments of Nissan, of course, EY and Rachel. It was close. There was a chance they could have overtaken them in Chicago. But Misty May Trainer and Kerri Walsh finished the regular season on top, came here as the number one seed, and they're proving that right now, up by three. Make that two. Great kill by Rachel.
Great attack choice out of the timeout. Rachel Wacholder shows the aggressive side and attacks that ball tough inside the right hand of Kerri Walsh. It's nice to come out of timeout and go for it a little bit.
That's right. Well, Mary hinted at the injury. You said you were noticing some body language as we went to break.
Yeah, it's just something I think you got to keep an eye on.
What a serve.
I think EY uses it as her advantage. She'll get down, she'll get mad, maybe she'll yell. But that gets the crowd going and it gets her going. I think it works to their advantage.
No question. She loves to play off of adrenaline. She gets the trickle right there, and all of a sudden, we are tied. 16 each. And that will certainly get EY excited. There you see that leading tour stat, 165 aces this season.
Take a look at our net cam. That's called a let serve, and those do count. When they fall for you, as you see them celebrate,
you're so happy. Of course, the old rules, if it touched the net.
Well, when you're on the opposite
side,
and when you're on the opposite side of the net, that happens. You just say that is an awful rule.
Oh, and it falls again.
That is
EY has come up exactly here with three killer serves,
three in a row.
That's when you need a timeout, is right. And look where this lands. By a mile.
And that's where EY, you have to talk about her when you talk about MVP. I mean, this game is 16-13, and she's turned it around with her serve.
Let's take a listen.
Yeah, I think she's going to use that side. Okay. So get up the line hit. You got to lay out for the line shot. And be ready for the over Elaine's anyway. Towards your right.
Yeah.
Okay.
And she's wide. I'm
round of applause, these
never
teams.
Got that one within my hand. That's why I want to stand on the inside of her when she's off.
The other thing is, that just in case you don't get a point, you're siding out. They're kind of on to your with you. Is kind of like getting here. So maybe just run it back, or maybe do a push it or something. Move it. Just now.
Swing is really good too. Yeah. When you swing high against Kerri.
Right. But sometimes you feel trapped with you if she's in your
I'm
face.
Yeah, I'm getting her space.
Yeah. But just move it around, okay?
Liz Mazakayan, their coach, giving them some instructions. So, Geeter, you're the mastermind. What'd you hear in that huddle?
Well, no.
Look at that.
That's got some talent.
I think you can do that, Geeter. Come on.
Oh, yeah.
You do everything.
Well, nobody's better than Liz Mazakayan out there. She's just a phenomenal player and a great coach. She's talking about giving Misty May the line right now. They're going to try to drop in on her angle. And EY talked about it, said it just went through her hands the last time, and she almost had it right there.
Well, a great run, compliments of EY's serving, comes to a close. We're tied at 17, but EY brought him back into it.
And EY was telling Rachel at the timeout, keep swinging aggressive, high hands. Try to go off the fingertips of Walsh.
Great placement once again. And this, as they say, my friend, is crunch time.
No question about it, Craig. 18-17. Especially after Wacholder and Young's down 16-13.
Now he's
coming back with those aces and now leading by one. Pressure's on Misty Kerri.
Rachel in her 80th tournament. Are they going to give it to her? And it just went wide, so that two-point, that ever-important two-point cushion now on the side of Rachel Wacholder and Elaine Youngs, 2 points away from coming out of this first game with a victory.
They're going to try to block Misty's angle and run down her line shot.
There was, but EY wants that one back.
She sneaks it by.
See
who Walsh serves here. Last time Misty served EY, just to give her one, I think they're going to go back to Rachel.
Well, again, that's an important component, isn't it? Mixing it up just when you get one person comfortable with the serve.
Good. That's it right there. I think Kerri wanted to pin her to the line to bring her outside the court. Easier to block, but she great pass, moved it right back into the middle. Look. look at this. We talked about it earlier. Bringing into the middle of the court. So tough to stop. She has every shot. She's got cross court. She can turn it back down the line.
Good for her 10th kill. EY with the serve has more aces than all three other people in this game combined. That time, though, it didn't help her out. 2019.
And that's something they've added to their game. They'll swing Misty May from the right side to the left side. It's not an easy play, but they make it look easy right there as Misty puts it away. But Kerri does a great job of bending down low and putting that bump set nice and high. Look for that a little later on in the match as well.
Still game point. They can close it out here. On two, and they've done it. Rachel Wacholder and Elaine have taken the first game here in Honolulu, 21-19. Take a look at the winning point. That gives them a 1-0 lead in games. One more, and they are in the final here at the Best of the Beach.
A lesson for parents about the power of your cable remote. Yes, you can surf the channels with it. But did you know? The cable remote can help control what your children watch. It's pretty easy. First hit menu or settings, then scroll through the on-screen options to set your password. Finally, block the programming by channel or rating. And talk to your children about why certain programs are not for them. Set your parental controls. It's easy. For more details on parental controls and tools, go to controlyourtv.org.
Three climate zones.
How's he doing back there?
Three rows of seats, so everyone can travel in comfort.
He's fine.
The all-new 7-passenger Jeep Commander. It's your world. Take command.
Sure, we had a good time pillaging. But with so many people switching to Capital One, we've had to find new jobs.
Maybe a 7.5.
It's been especially tough on Ivan the Great.
For low rates and great rewards, switch to Capital One.
What's in your wallet? What are you looking at?
The beach competition here in Honolulu, Hawaii. Craig Hummer, Chris McGee, and Mary Strong. Rachel converts, and she was not fooled by Kerri that time.
No, and they pinned her to the sideline right at the antenna, but Rachel with a great cut shot. Shot that Misty May and Holly McPeak do so well, and Rachel Wacholder has adopted that shot. So great on the right side. She has a nice little line shot, but her cut is just getting better and better each weekend.
Hey, go, go, go.
Speaking of cut shots, that was incredible right there. Misty May, did it even go over the net? It's like stealth.
The thing that people might not realize is the margin for error there is so small. She's off the net, into the middle of the court. There's just only a couple feet you can put that ball.
Big power from the right-hand side, cross court by Rachel.
And there's the strong hands of EY, the great setter that she's become. Playing with Holly McPeak all those years, she was always handling the second ball, never getting served. She's become a great setter. You're able to contact that twice in that situation. So block counts as one. Misty May sees that Rachel's up front. She just puts it right to the back line.
All the way up middle, all the way up.
They had a 16-13 lead in game one. Now it's 14-12 in game two. Rachel yet again puts it away.
Walsh decides to retreat from the net, leaving nobody up.
And she splits them. Both of them retreating.
Yeah, that's called termination. Set.
Get chances.
with the handset, though, that's something we can talk about as the year goes on. She was a great setter. Look at this dig by Rachel. Misty was a great setter in college. There she breaks out those paws. Look at that back set. Walsh with a finish down the line.
Perfect backhand set. If you're keeping score at home, mark that moment of the TiVo. That's what you need to practice. Learn that one. Off the tape. Good to close within two again.
I tell you, that's twice in a row that Kerri Walsh has retreated off the net, and Rachel's put it in her perfect spot, right down the middle, splitting the two. Karchi always says, the fiddle, hit it in the middle.
Well, you got to have a mind like a computer, don't you? You have to be able to just decide within a millisecond. Oh, the EY.
There it is.
Thought it was going to fall.
I love it and it frightens me at the same time when she yells.
Yeah.
Great intensity.
Same score we had in game one. This is when it was a 4-0 run for EY and Rachel.
Play, you know, Dane Selznick, we had the mic on him at the timeout, and he said urge each other to swing hard for points. Right there, Misty May gobbles it up on the dig, shoots the line, Rachel ends up converting off the dig. Got to be aggressive there.
Deja vu.
It's such a great play. We're going to play the entire thing. The stuff block was about to go down. What a great cover. Oh, Walsh with the reaction. Amazing in that gold medal bounce. Walsh so relaxed. Took a look. The ball's a couple feet away from her. She's in the air. She takes a look. Sees Rachel going one way. Hits it the other.
Court presence. Rachel, no touch. So miss hit now has given a 4-point cushion back to May and Walsh.
And that's the one problem you might have when you bring that ball into the middle for the set and the attack, and it's pushed over a little too much. There's no room over there across court. Over.
Could be that ankle. Yeah, it looks as though, Geeter, we might have an injury timeout.
You wouldn't know it by her play.
No, absolutely.
She's playing very well, but you can tell she's in some pain. Mary Strong talked about it earlier. It's just been gradually going up the leg.
Medical staff here will perhaps be called out. Discussion between the two. If she wants to call it, she can have a 5-minute medical timeout. Testing it right there.
Yeah, there she is right there. If you see, she caught it in the sand. It looks like she rolled it just a little.
A couple times. We've talked about how deep the sand is. You're right, Geeter. There she goes down. It looks as though it just rolled.
Great job by our guys in the truck.
Good, right here, right here. Touch. Line over, line over. Go,
Kerri. Misty May finishes it, and it looks like we are on the verge of going to game number three, partner.
I think you're right, Greg. Misty May, Kerri Walsh. have got a little momentum, you know, and both of them talk about this. When they're earning points off their serve, the game is so easy for them. And right now they're in that groove. Walsh is getting a couple blocks, and Misty May is just unstoppable defensively.
To go back to what you've highlighted a couple times, Dane telling them, just feed off yourselves. Eli with no approach, just got up, delivered it. Just a little lift. This nice little...
Just so nonchalant, you'll see her right hand come out here and she'll just flip it up.
Oh, ball's there. Thank you.
That's called years of practice, Craig.
Yeah.
I think if you tried that, it ball's going to the ocean.
Into the ocean or off your noggin, one or the other, partner. I wouldn't be scoring a point, that's for sure. Another chance, multiple chances at game point.
Oh,
just wide.
Just wide.
Interesting, the other line guy was off the net,
but here's,
or less.
Geeter, here's another scenario, right? Let's just say, I mean, they've got so many chances at game point, but what you don't want to do is allow this full momentum switch. So when you come out for game number three.
Michael,
no!
Absolutely.
And there we go. Yet another miscue. And all of a sudden, May and Walsh unraveling just a bit. They have that cushion. But mentally, and it falls. So it seemed inevitable. And this is it. We are tied at one each. May and Walsh win game number two. Game number two, Geeter, we are knotted at ones. Let's talk a little bit about the finish of game two, and perhaps is the momentum one way or the other at the moment?
I think right now it definitely is with May Trainer and Walsh. I know EY and Rachel made a little bit of a run there at the end, but Misty May and Kerri Walsh, the way that they beat them, by digging balls, blocking balls, serving tough, getting in that side-out rhythm, that's the way they play. That's why they've won 13 of 16 tournaments. That's why they're the number one team in the world.
Well, I think the key word that you just hit on right there is rhythm. They finally got in a rhythm. They finally actually were able to dictate the rhythm to the other team.
Absolutely, but this is, that all changes now when you go to game three. No matter what momentum has been doing in game one and two, game three is a shortened game. It's only played to 15 points. If EY can get that serve going early, Rachel maybe can get some digs early. You don't want to be behind in this situation, so momentum is going to start now. We'll see who gets it.
All right, well, we've touched on momentum. Let's touch a little bit more on pressure. We talked about it early on in the match. Now that we've gotten to a game three, do you see anybody tensing up?
You know, I don't. I think these guys have been here so many times in this situation, seeing it a game three, playing against each other, whether it's in a final or a semifinal. I don't think the pressure is going to get to them, and I think they're both going to go at it.
Well, we will find out soon enough. Game three coming up here from the beaches of Honolulu.
This Wednesday, Survivor on OLN is moving to a new night and heading...
Points, 7-3. Craig Hummer, Chris McGee, as well as Mary Strong bringing to the action. This to decide who goes on to the Best of the Beach final here in Honolulu. Kerri Walsh putting it in play. Nice answer by Rachel.
Rachel with that quick attack that they've talked about so many times. Off a low, fast set, she comes in firing. Favorite shot, that hard cross-court angle.
Doing everything they can to stay with the number one seeded team. They need EY's service genius.
And that's why Misty May is so good. You hear both teams talking in the timeout about Misty's cut shot and a hard angle shot. And right there, she shoots it down the line in a perfect location. To the back line, no room for error.
Misty May. Elaine, Kerri Walsh, good for the point. Well, it's funny, we talk about the big dig, which may become our new stat eater that we've just invented as it applies to Misty May, but, you know, her husband, Matt Traynor, catcher for the Florida Marlins, might not like this reference, but, you know, Misty's like Mariano Rivera, you know, she's just the closer. I mean, when it's time to come in and just shut it down, she shuts the other team down.
I like it, Greg.
All right, well,
you're right. Nobody's better at it. That's why in Colorado, when they were up 12-9, and Misty hit a few balls out and they lost, everyone in the volleyball world was shocked because they'd never seen her not close out a game.
They lead by 4, and once again, Kerri Walsh with the serve. 9 serving 5, 6 points away from advancing to the final.
You know, you talk about MVPs, and Kerri Walsh is a 2-time MVP. But Misty May Traynor has had a phenomenal year. Have to think about that as an MVP choice.
In amazing game 3, they're up by 5.
Have they called a timeout?
Game 5. It looks as though there is a medical timeout. Medical timeout on the court. We will be back to get an update when we return. But in game number 3, Misty May and Kerri Walsh have doubled up. EY and Rachel, they lead 10-5.
Horsepower and torque than Ford or Dodge. Paper flowers? Tin cans? Come on. I love weddings.
Chevy Silverado, an American revolution.
I've been in this room before.
You took the virtual tour at hotels.com?
Right.
Want to check out your hotel before you check in? Send in the experts at hotels.com. They check out thousands of hotels and bring you tools like virtual tours so you can look before you book. Log on or call now to find great deals everywhere. Hotels.com. We know hotels inside and out.
Have you ever wanted to develop your artistic abilities? If so, you may already have the interest and desire needed to become a serious art student. To find out, simply call toll-free, and Art Instruction Schools will send you this enjoyable art test. There's no cost or obligation. Take the test at home in your spare time and mail it to us when you're done. Our experts will review and score your test. Since 1914, we've helped thousands of aspiring artists become more skilled, more confident, and more creative in their art. Whether you're interested in realism or fantasy, figure drawing or cartooning, you can pursue your vision under the expert guidance of our talented instructors. Call today for your free art test. We'll help you become a better artist. Call 1-800-426-8282.
Welcome back to the AVP Paul Mitchell Best of the Beach. An earlier injury to Rachel Wacholder. Of course, she has had that left ankle taped. It has been a problem throughout this match. She is now back on the court, but for more, let's send it down to Mary Strong.
Well, Craig, just a moment ago, Rachel had to call a medical timeout because her tape was coming loose, so she got it retaped and tightened by her coach, Liz. As I mentioned earlier, her ankle is very weak, and it's causing problems and bothering her a lot. The sand keeps loosening her tape, and she says that it's really difficult to play on it right now.
Do her best to fight through. Thank you, Mary. Kerri Walsh, I'm sure, in the back of her mind, never likes to beat down on somebody that's got an injury, but she's thinking more about getting to the finals, and they have a six-point lead right now.
Yeah, if you look, too, I thought maybe that they were going to go to that Karai formation, the I formation, like that full-back, tailback, which Karch and Lambeau had to do last year when Karch was hurt. But if you look, EY's just moved more into the middle of the court, and Rachel's moved more towards the sideline. They're kind of daring them to go at EY the other way, but
they continue to increase their lead. 7-point lead now. Make that 8. So everything going right.
Yeah,
for Misty May and Kerri Walsh, the 5th kill.
You can just tell on the looks on their faces, EY and Rachel, that this one is pretty much in the bag for Kerri and Misty.
EY, a little bit of fire left. Take nothing away, though, from Misty May and Kerri Walsh. Absolutely dominating play in game 2, and that carried over into game number 3.
And if you're EY here, just go up and unload on it.
Nothing to lose.
Nothing to lose. If anybody can do it on the tour, it's her.
Yeah. Ace leader on tour. Into the net. That point takes us to the turn at 20, so 7 serving 13. We've seen it rarely have Misty May and Kerri Walsh lost that first game, and when they do, they make you work for it to come back against them. Just not enough by EY and Rachel. That brings us to match point here in the women's semifinal. Misty May and Kerri Walsh hoping to advance. Paul Mitchell, best of the beach, a chance to go up against Jen Kessie and Holly McKee. Not yet, though.
EY does a nice job, a little tap shot. Gives her partner a little slap, says, let's go.
May and Walsh have had the success in big chunks so far this match. Runs of 5-0, 4-0, another 4-0, even 5-1. Misty May's expertise on the cross court ends it, Peter.
That's it right there, Misty May. She went to that cut shot all day long, and she goes to it again to end the match, and May and Walsh were just too tough during game 2 and 3 to stop.
You see EY and Rachel out on the court cheering for those who will advance. Misty May Trainer, Kerri Walsh, the number one seeded team on tour, have done it yet again. They have advanced through the semifinals. This concludes our coverage of the women's semifinals, where again, Misty May Trainer and Kerri Walsh defeated Rachel Wacholder and Elaine Young's 2-1. The first game didn't go their way. The second two did, 21-17 and 15-8. Well, stay tuned, because coming up next, we are going to have coverage of the men's semifinals for Chris McGee and Mary Strong. I'm Craig Ummer. Stick with us, gang. We'll be back to Hawaii after this.